Welcome to Road to Billions Podcast, the mentality of an entrepreneur, with your host, Moise Bertrand.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It is your host, Moise Bertrand, the Road to Billions Podcast. Today, we have a very special guest, man. You know, this young brother, I've seen him doing great things. I met him a few times. Just over the course of just a couple of years, like 2-3 years. I remember the first time I met him, I didn't really know who he was. But after I followed him on Instagram, I really do respect his grind now. A great fashion designer, someone who's very young, killing the game and celebrities, just putting people up on game, branding, make sure everybody looks tidy and apart. So today we have Withney Simon today, man. How you doing today, boss?
Man, I'm blessed. Thank you for having me.
Man, definitely, man. I appreciate you coming on the show. For those who don't know you, just give them a little background about who you are as a person, where are you from? Just let us know a little bit about yourself, you know?
For those who don't know me, I am Withney Simon. I am an entrepreneur, personal trainer. I'm also a fashion designer, as he mentioned. Originally from Haiti, moved from Haiti 2003, started playing football, highly involved in sports, got a full ride scholarship, played at Southern Illinois University, where I met a lot of my clients and great friends. After graduating from Southern Illinois, I decided to take upon the fashion industry, which is where I started Phame Fashion, Phame Fashion. From there, it was just God leading me into a path where a lot of doors and opportunities was being opened to me, presented to me.
Definitely. So, just tell us about what made you go into fashion. Like, I know for those who don't know you and for those who are going to follow you after this, they will see, like, you're pretty built up. But, why did you go into fashion particularly? Why that area? Why not business? Why not everything else? Like, tell us why specifically fashion.
So fashion speak a high volume of this world, right? Fashion have its own language. So a person might not, let me go back. So when I first moved from Haiti, I did not speak English. So my attire had to make up for me not speaking English. Like, for me, fashion is a common language to everybody. If you have something neat and clean on, everybody's gonna be like, yo, that's nice, that's clean,
right?
No matter who you are, like, they're gonna be like, okay, that's nice, you rocking that. If the person is a great person and they understand fashion. So I just was like, okay, let me get into fashion. My uncle put me on designer at an early age. So I started wearing designers. I started wearing the street attires. So I just started doing things on a creative way. So once I got to college, I started dressing all my teammates for our banquets, for like sports events and outside just going to class and stuff. I started dressing them. And from there, it took off. Once those boys went to the NFL and stuff, they started like, okay, I don't need no other stylists. I already have my stylists since college.
Man, that's a blessing. So when you was working with these players and obviously your friends, did you feel like your style was not going to be accepted in the beginning? Did you feel like people were going to like ridicule you? Like, tell us about that. Tell us about being confident, just like what you wear, because I'm always looking at your page and you're always clean with suits and everything. You always know how to mix and match. But like, what got you to that point to be like, listen, I could really start designing and styling others?
Man, because, bro, people going to speak regardless, yo. And then they understand that people always going to have something to say, either if it's good or it's bad. Like, I don't care about what people have to say. I really don't, yeah. Bro. Like, I really move off my intention, because I know my intention is pure. So I'm a pure guy. So, okay, I move off pureness and, like, I let everything else speak for itself. I don't care about what nobody has to say. And I only listen to a higher up, which is God. I speak to him. I talk to him. You feel me? That's the only person that like that can really be like, okay, no, you good. I don't listen to nobody.
Yeah. Yeah. That's real. That's real. So tell us about your upbringing, though, because I know you're Haitian. I'm Haitian. You know, we Zoes, that's what we call each other. But tell us about like when you first told your parents, did you tell your parents you was going to go into fashion? That's the first question. Matter of fact.
No, actually, the goal was for me to go to the NFL. My football career got shortened after a bad concussion that I had went into a seizure. After that happened, I told myself, nah, I'm not even going to move on with football no more. I'm just going to, like, use my brain and do things that I want. And my parents always been supportive. My parents always, like, especially my mother. My mother always been supportive of everything that I have done, and she's always been giving me her free will, like, okay, you can do it. You can do it. She always, like, telling me, like, you can do something. Even if it seemed impossible at the beginning, she always letting me know, okay, you can achieve it. You can achieve it. If it's already in your mind, you can achieve it. And my dad always told me, keep my face clean, and everything else will play its part. So my family, I can say my family raised me right. My mother, my dad, they disciplined us. Like, of course, you know how Haitians are. We get spankings, yo. I used to get like real life, like for real. I used to real life get spanking, but like it made me into the man that I am today. At an early age, I had to mature. I had to be mature. Because I didn't want to keep, you feel me? You're like, well, you don't want to keep getting spanking. Yeah. So it's like, so you got to act right. So I started acting right at an early age. I just grew up early. So my parents raised me to be a man early. And that's what people been seeing.
Yeah, I really do respect that. I feel like that's a lot of things that go in the Haitian household. Like, they build us up so we can't depart from their ways. Like, if they tell you to do that, that's forever in your head.
At all. And the beauty about it is they also teach you, like, as a man, like, to have respect for women, especially, yo. They really teach you that.
Yeah.
So that's why I really value my upbringing. My upbringing was, like, I was grateful for it.
That's real. So, Withney, quick question as well. I know you're a very visionary person. So how do you see yourself in the next, I don't want to ask you this because you may not want to tell your goals, but can you give us a little bit about like the insight about how you want your future to be shaped? Like, do you want to open your own fashion firm? Do you want to have people working under you? Like, let us know about.
Well, that's easy to talk about because I want a dynasty, yo. I'm building a dynasty right now. I'm in the process of building a dynasty. And understanding the dynasty is not easy to build. It's not going to be built within 1 year, 2 years. It's a work in progress right now. So I'm working on a dynasty. So with that being said, like, I'm working on a dynasty, building a dynasty where the Phame experience, the Phame of fashion, the Phame sweat, the Phame fitness, all of it going to be, it's going to be more than just one brand.
Definitely. Okay. Yeah, that's dope, man, because you know, we don't have a lot of Haitians in that area of industry. What I haven't met a lot of Haitians. It's always like everybody else who's a different culture, but I really want you to put on for the culture, man, because you're doing great things, man. And I'm always gonna tell you that. I think I told you that last time when I seen you at the party. I'm like,
Fact. You definitely did. And yeah, that's the one thing about you too, Moses. I'm gonna give you your flowers where you're given, bro. Cause like, bro, I met you. I thought, like, to be honest with you, I thought you was shy and calm, but you are really, bro, you are very outspoken and articulate, bro. Bro, you are a very dope individual too, bro. Like, your friends, you that too. So I just want to give you your flowers.
Man, I appreciate it. You know, we living out here in I think the funny joke we said when we was at the party, the Kappa party, was like, we living out here in Atlanta, it ain't easy. And then we both gave each other salute for that, because we know living in Atlanta, the rent's going crazy, you know, and we entrepreneurs already. So, yeah, man, like, for everybody who's listening, like, we doing it out here. You guys can do it as well. And, you guys can see the possibilities are endless. But so tell us a little bit about, because I know I have a lot of college students who listen to this podcast as well. For anybody who's trying to get into the fashion industry, let us know how they could first even get into it. What are some things they could start, you know, messing with and just, you know, toggling with, if you just mind dropping some gems on that.
All right, first gem is really your confidence. You already got to have that confidence where you don't care about what nobody or anybody say about you, like your looks. Because fashion is an expression. You're expressing yourself. People got to understand this. Like, once you wear something, you are expressing yourself. So understand, like, express yourself. Be bold. Be creative. Like, don't be scared. Like, you have your own. And one more thing, like, see yourself as the brand. You are the brand. See yourself as the brand. Don't see yourself less than the executives or the founder. See yourself, I am a brand. So you carry yourself as a brand. Those are the gems, really, bro. Like, just carry yourself as what you are, what you say you are. If you want to be into fashion, shoot, start acting like you're already that fashion person. Like, when Virgil passed away, bro, it was so sad for me, right? So a lot of people was talking like, damn, he passed away. But I looked at it as an opportunity when I was like, damn, he really created a way for young people to be creative,
right?
To be bold, to open up our mind and be like, okay, I don't care. Like, if one person that I know don't support what I have going on, my story is going to reach 1,000 more people. You feel me? So that's what Virgil was like, okay, he wants us to be more creative. And if we think we worth something, hey, that's what you worth.
Yeah. Yeah. And I feel like that's a big thing with us. You know, just knowing that when you're starting your own thing is not going to be easy. Like, a lot of people, they fall victim to thinking everybody's going to support them, when it really comes down to self-confidence at the end of the day. And you exude, you know, you exuding that. You're working with high players, high fashion, high celebrities, and you're doing your thing. So there's really no limit to your success, no roof. So when you're working with these brands and when you're working with celebrities, do you feel like they may not like the style, or did you have times where they'd be like, nah, I don't want that? And you know, kind of hurt your feelings. Like, you know, let us know transparency, because I know you may not.
Transparency, bro. Like, to be honest with you, like, I had some clients who like, no, I'm not wearing something. And like, it's okay. It's okay, because like, at the end of the day, I'm going to always put my input and your ideas together. Like, we going to, like, my goal is to always, okay, we working together. Our heads are in this together. Two is better than one. So right. I'm going to put my input. And then, like, whatever you feel like you got put in to make yourself feel confident, hey, add it. Because at the end of the day, you are the person wearing the clothes.
Right, right.
So you got to make yourself as confident as you need to. I'm just here. I'm giving you my input. You taking my input, and then you putting your little pieces in it. Hey, that's how we go. Like, my clients love me, bro, because we actually have more relationships away from just styling. It's just like, okay, I can be real transparent with them, and they can be real transparent with me.
Yeah, that's what it comes down to: transparency and honesty. I don't know if you, well, I know more than likely you looked into this, but Steve Harvey, he was never dressing the way he was dressing. Like, we
exactly.
All, so like, tell us about that. Tell us about how you've seen his style evolutionize, not only himself, but his brand. Like, because we know, we always talk about how fashion could take somebody from not being known to being seen. So like, let us know a little bit about your input with that.
All right. Steve Harvey, like, to be honest, I love the way that he's dressing now, because he's older, right? But guess what? He look younger.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's older, but he look younger. Why? Because now he understand I gotta stay fit. I gotta be well groomed. I gotta be manicured. I gotta be pampered. I got to look a certain type of way to make these clothes feel that. So I love how the whole transition from all the big baggy suits to the slim tailor fit Italian cuts suits now. I love the whole transition because, like we just say, he looked older, but he is younger. He's living his best life right now, really.
Yeah, yeah. And we see his wife smiling all the time. All the time she with him now. She could pop out with him now. So
facts. So that's that. Fashion play a big difference. And guess what? More people are like more in tune with Steve Harvey shows because, like, okay, dang, you look better. You are your brand. Remember, you look better. Like, you are in a whole different category now.
Yeah, they tuning in every night to see what he's gonna wear next.
Right.
Like, that's really a statement. So when you're like, I know a lot of industry rappers and celebrities, they're always going through the process of having stylists. Do you feel like a person should have one stylist or multiple stylists in order to like fit their vision? Do you feel like one person should just work with a stylist their whole career?
I feel like they should have one. And here's why I say one. Because you want to work with somebody that you loyal to, yo. Like, you don't want to have many people and different people in your life and your ears. Because when you start switching team, that's when, like, okay, things start getting, like, people going to start spreading rumors, boom, boom, you feel me? That's how rumors, all that bad, negative stuff start happening. Right. So, I feel like, if you loyal with one person, hey, that's why you loyal with one person. It's for a reason. It shows. It shows your loyalty and the type of person that you is.
It does. Loyalty takes people far. I mean, they don't really understand that. Like, that's anything in life. Like, that's in business, that's in relationships, that's in love. Loyalty is the foundation of a lot of starts. So whenever, because, you know, I'm always looking to get knowledge out of you because I'm asking you these questions because it may be people who may not be able to speak to you directly, but I know what you have to offer could be very vital. So can you let us know, like, what some things you do, particularly in fashion, like some things, maybe somebody who listens to this podcast will reach out to you and will work with you. So let us know a little about services you have to offer and things you specialize in.
All right. So my services, I'm a luxurious fashion travel designer. So I travel to all my clients. And if we tailoring something and if we getting some measurements, I travel to them. I bring them the books and we go over fabrics, we go over buttons, we go over them, like the whole lining, the interior that goes inside the jackets. So we go over the whole package really. And from there I will go back and send my measurements to my manufacturer, which is working with my brother's V12, the V12 collection.
Right.
The V12 collection is a luxurious suit line for men and women. We send that overseas, and then from there they get ready on the process. And with the fashion side, as in like just dressing somebody, I go to the person. I travel to the person. Pick out their colors, what colors we doing, and go back and shop. My mind is very creative. I do not shop with no guide or handbook. Everything that I do is straight off the dome. So I will go to the store, I will imagine the person and something that I see. Mm-hmm. And I will piece the ideas together. And then that outfit will come exactly how I see it.
Yeah, yeah, man. You definitely give me the vibes of a bit of Jerry Lorenzo, you know. You know, you give me the vibes of Jerry Lorenzo and Kanye because, you know, Conway, Kanye never gives like two fucks about what nobody ever thinks about him and not always admired about you. Like, you always stuck to your guns. But when you're working with, when you were first starting in fashion, like, was it hard to get someone to pay you? Like, let's, because I know people always want to say, okay, you're starting into fashion, but like, how is that structured? Do you get paid off marketing? Do you get paid off the consultation? Or like, how do you, like, if we don't want to get too much into your business, but just give, because we may have someone who wants to start being a fashion designer. They may reach out to you and they want to structure their business similar to yours. So like, how would you go about things like that? Do you charge for a consultation, XYZ?
I do charge for a consultation, but at the same time, his free game, I'm about to tell people right now, it doesn't matter what people think about, it's how much do you think you're worth. I know my worth. Coming into a game, you got to know your worth. Anything that you go into, you got to know what you bring to the table. And I know what I bring to the table and like the time that I put in to bring what I'm bringing to the table. So it's like you have to know your worth in order for you to come up with your price. Like my price is for a certain group of people. Only a few can afford me, and that's cool. I'm okay with only it's a lot that can afford me, but like the majority can't, and I'm okay with that. Yeah. So you have to know who you're selling to. You have to know it's quality over quantity.
Definitely. Yeah, that's one of the biggest things, knowing your self-worth. So, you know, we're not going to keep you too long, but we want to get some advice from you, like any gems or any advice you want to drop to the listeners or to anybody who wants to reach out to you. Like, let us know your whole full panhandle. Let us know a little bit of advice and gems you want to drop to anybody who's listening and any encouragement you want to give to anybody who really don't know what they want to do in life right now.
Bet. Well, here's some advice I'm going to give y'all. It's two books that helped me and guide me through this whole journey that I'm going to do right now. So if you really want to start and take control of your life and what you want out of life and to become, so The Magic of Thinking Big by David Schwartz, I'll definitely read that.
Yeah,
and Think and Grow Rich. Those are the two books that have helped me and shaped me into the person that I'm becoming. So those are the two advice I can really give you. If you read these two books, they say a lot of us don't like reading. So let's prove them wrong. And hey, everything that we want out of life, we have it inside of us. We have it inside of us. It's just take the power within to move it. And once you start, can't nobody stop you but yourself.
I definitely agree. Can you let us know how to reach you? How can others reach you? Your Instagram, even your email. Like how could someone reach you?
You can reach me on Instagram at Phame Fashion, Phame Fashion, INK. And then you can also follow my personal training page at Phame Fitness, which is Phame Fitness. Those are the two pages that I'm going off right now. So, hey, if you want to get that workout in too, I'm also a personal trainer, and we can work something out and go there.
Definitely, man. I appreciate you, Whitney, for like coming on the podcast, dropping gems, because a lot of people don't have time to just, you know, speak about their experiences, especially dealing with entrepreneurship. But like I said, once again, man, I really do appreciate you. I wish you much more abundance and success in your journey. And for all those who are listening to this podcast, please reach out, because I know a lot of you guys want to be fashion designers, or, you know, you guys have the aspiration to dress nice. But I'm telling you guys, Whitney is one of those guys I see on Instagram. He's killing the game. And the only thing I see for him is just keep going up in the ladder. So you guys get in contact with him before he gets too big. Like, you know, that's to keep it real with you guys. But he's here, and he's looking to help you guys in any way or form. So I appreciate you guys for listening to Rolling Business Podcast. It's been an amazing journey. And Withney, I really appreciate you coming on the show once again, boss.
I appreciate you, bro.
Take it. All right, you guys.